Tony and Dusty, as you know, I'm back here with the total package, Lex Luger, and I must say, I feel very confident to be standing by this man, and I'm certainly proud of his actions last Sunday night at World War III. Lex, you finally stepped up to the plate representing World Championship Wrestling, confronting the NWO in that big 60-man, three-ring battle royal. The numbers, of course, certainly outweighed you, but you got the Giant up in the rack. You got Kevin Nash up in the rack. And a lot of the fellow members of World Championship Wrestling, mighty proud of you. Job well done.
Well, you know, where there's hope, you know, when you get a guy like the Giant in the rack, when you get a guy like Kevin Nash in the rack, they've been having their way with everyone in World Championship Wrestling, but they show vulnerability. If there's a will, there's a way. But WCW, they're all going their own way. They're all separate. There's not one man. I don't care how aggressive you are. I don't care how out of control you are. I don't care what you say you want to fight fire with fire, NWO style. One man is not going to get the job done. I'm not saying that to discount myself, but it's going to take a cohesive group effort on the part of WCW and the history that stands behind us to pull this thing out.
I think what we have to do is a lot of the men here at World Championship Wrestling have got to set aside the personal issues and galvanize. If not, it is not going to be good for World Championship Wrestling with the NWO hovering out there. Now, one other thing that I want to confront you with here on Saturday night. As I mentioned in the past, if anybody knows Sting, Lex Luger knows Sting, but I am really beginning to wonder. I mean, it doesn't seem to make any difference. Friend or foe, he's going after everybody.
You know, it's very frustrating for me personally. I know it's for the fans out there. It is frustrating for WCW officials and people such as yourself. We've all known Sting for very many years and what he represents, but right now, I don't know what he represents. He's dressed in black and white. He's carrying baseball bats around. That all smells of NWO. And we all hope, we all pray, like I said before, that that doesn't happen. But right now, I don't know where he's coming from, Gene.
Well, usually in the past, if it looks like a duck, if it quacks like a duck, something's wrong.
Let's hope not.
Yeah, you bet. Stay tuned. We've got more after this.